I had to delete my last video because it's a lot of profanity in it. And I got a little animated. So, I'm sorry. Big Boss K-Po Top Boxing. Mono Greatness video dropping today. Go over to that channel, check it out. Let me tell you something about that, right? So, we've been having issues, you know, with getting videos out, right? We're sending our videos to people in... they're not getting them done in a timely manner. So we had to basically scrap a lot of videos because by the time the video dropped, the fight didn't either happened or the football game already happened already. You know? So it's like, it's no point for us to drop this video when the game already happened already. You see what I'm saying? So we got a new protocol. We got a new approach. We're doing this shit ourselves. You know, so y'all be on the lookout, man. We had to, you know, we just got some things we still got to iron out with some people on the podcast. But like I say, for the most part, the podcast still green lighted, man. We still going to push out. You know what I'm saying? You might see two of us. You might see three of us. You might see, you know, minimum you're going to see two of us consistently, you know. That's just what it is. It just depends on, you know, what's going on. But Mono Greatness Podcast still coming. It's still pushing. Now, Terrence Crawford goes on a rant. He got his feelings, guys. Terrence Crawford gets into his feelings. Let's talk about it. He had a therapy session on Twitter or whatever, XYZ, whatever you want to call it, yesterday. So Terrence Crawford says that Danny Garcia and Keith Thurman. Now, granted, I don't know where this came from, but I'm going to do my full reaction in a minute. Terrence Crawford goes on a rant about Danny Garcia and Keith Thurman, and basically says they're not going to get a fight with him. He's not fighting him. He said, y'all didn't want to fight me when I was coming up, so y'all not going to get no fight now. And he was like, y'all can fight each other, you know, but y'all never going to fight me. Well, I'm never getting in the ring with you. You know, y'all can... you know, kick rocks, basically. That's what he said. He said, you know, y'all didn't give me a shot, so y'all trying to get paid now, but y'all didn't want to give me that opportunity. So, you know, kick rocks. That's basically what Terrence Crawford said. Then he proceeds to go on about how, you know, they created size of the street. Basically, that bull jive about they tried to freeze him out and all this other bull crap, which I'm finna cook in a minute. Just give me a second. Then he starts talking about YouTubers, how YouTubers are. The YouTubers, he must be really butthurt and affected by the YouTubers. You know what I'm saying? This is like the 20th time he done brought that shit up. You know what I'm saying? If I was Terrence Crawford, the money I'm making, I don't give a damn what a YouTuber say. I don't care. I don't care what nobody say. All I care about is the people that matter on my team. That's it. It's the same thing now with me and my life. Like, man, I got like 2-3 people I fool with. My circle very small. You know what I'm saying? You know, that's what it is. Those the people opinion that matter. Everybody else opinion, man. I hear you out. I'm not a fool. You know what I'm saying? But. I'm going to go to them 2-3 people before I go to anybody else. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is. If I need some advice or I need to talk or whatever. You know? This nigga, like, really bothered by these YouTubers. Like, the YouTubers, like, bro, I don't understand his logic. You know what I'm saying? Like, worrying about, I wouldn't give a damn. I wouldn't give a damn. I would give a damn now. And I ain't, you know, millionaire. I don't give a damn now. What? Man, I don't give a damn about none of that shit. That's my mindset. Huh? You said, I don't give a damn about none of that shit. But to get back on topic, right? To get back on topic. My reaction to him about, you know, talking about Daniel Garcia, Keith Thurman. For starters, if he stay at 147, he gonna have to fight Keith Thurman because Keith Thurman is the manager for the WBC belt. So next. As it comes down to Danny Garcia. Danny Garcia is at 154. To my knowledge, he's going to fight Erslan Ilara at a catchweight. So, I don't know, you know, why he bringing up Danny Garcia. Only thing I can think of, if I saw a Fight Hub interview recently with Marcus Villegas, shout out to him, he interviewed Danny Garcia. And they were talking about a fight with Terrence Crawford. And Danny Garcia didn't really seem, he said he'll fight Terrence Crawford, but he didn't seem really like, yeah, I'll fight him. He was more like, yeah, I'll fight him. You know, it was like, it didn't seem convincing to me. Like he really wanted that smoke. Like, hell yeah. You know, it was more like, yeah, I'll fight him, yeah. You know, that's the vibe I got. I may be wrong, but that's the vibe I got. I think Danny Garcia, like, is at the point where, like, he not all in on boxing. Like, that's just real talk. I don't feel like he all in on boxing. I feel like he just doing it just to be doing it at this point. And if I feel like if you're a fighter and you like that, man, just do exhibitions. I mean, he could do an exhibition. Danny Garcia can make decent money doing exhibitions. Stop fighting these YouTubers. Yo, go fight Jake Paul. You know what I mean? If I'm Danny Garcia, I go fight Jake Paul. F it. You know what I mean? Like, it is what it is. Like, you know, but get out the game. You know, you can't be sitting here talking about, you know, you a fighter and you, you know, want to be a champion again, but you ain't fighting the top guys at your division. I don't get that. So that's questionable to boss. But other than that, that's the only reason why I see Terrence Crawford going to Danny Garcia is because Danny Garcia was interviewed the other day and Terrence Crawford was brought up. You know what I mean? That's the only reason why I sit there and say, okay, this is the reason, you know, why he came for Danny Garcia. So that's that. Like I said, the YouTube thing. I don't understand why this nigga is so bothered by that. It was like a therapy session for him. He keep talking about YouTubers, bro. Like, I don't understand what his logic is. You ain't fought nobody, bro. Your only win is Errol. That's just what it is. Ain't no, you can say whatever you want to say. He ain't fought nobody but Errol. That's it. That's the first credible name that he fought on his resume is Errol Spence. You know, I said this in the last video. Dudes bringing up, oh, Sean Porter got a better resume than both of them. We talking about Errol and Terrence Crawford. That's what we talking about. Right? The only fighter that Terrence Crawford got on his resume is Errol Spence. That's it. That's the only win I give him. Like, I'm like, finally. You see what I'm saying? Finally. And this is not a knock. See, when people, and let me say this. Terrence Crawford thinks when you say things like this about him, he's taking it as like, oh, you saying I can't fight. That's not what that means. We're saying a fighter of your caliber should have been fighting these fights. But then, to segue into the next thing, he's talking about, oh, y'all came over the sides of the street. If I'm not mistaken, it was your promoter that came out and said, I will not work with Al Haymon, right? His promoter was saying that. Have y'all ever heard, and nobody can say this, nobody can ask this question. Have you ever heard PBC, anybody PBC said, we will not work with nobody else? Go find a video and let me know that. Because all y'all do is speculate. Oh, PBC don't want to work, or PBC don't want to send a fight. How is it PBC fault that you ain't get them fights? Another thing, if it was PBC fault that you didn't get them fights, why did you leave Top Rank? Why? Why did you leave Top Rank? If it was PBC's fault, right, you would still be signed to Top Rank, if I'm not mistaken, right? You sued Top Rank. You even said in the interview, I can't get the, you couldn't secure me these fights, so I'm going on with my career. If it was PBC's fault that he couldn't get these fights, this nigga would still be signed to Top Rank. And when you talk to Bud, but it's about the, well, no, he left Top Rank because they weren't marketing him right. That ties in with him getting fights, securing fights. But I'll tell y'all this. How is it that PBC wanted to block him out or shell him out or whatever? But PBC is the one always sending their fighters to other networks. Name the last time Top Rank sent a top fighter of theirs to another network to fight. I'ma wait patiently. In the last 10 years, name a fighter that Top Rank had that they sent, right, from their network to fight on another network, a top fighter. Okay? I'll be waiting. Since it's always PBC fault. It's always PBC fault. That's what I'm saying. Everybody want to point the blame at PBC. It's easy to say PBC because Al Heyman ain't talking. Al Heyman don't do all that talking. He don't need to talk. He don't need to say shit. He just like, man, I'm Al Heyman, nigga. I don't give a fuck about what you talking about. I make millions of dollars. I don't care. I make a fuck out. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's real talk. We got to call spade a spade. You ever know that Al Heyman don't say nothing? Yeah, we barely even know this nigga. We don't even know if the picture we see on Google is really Al Heyman. We just gonna keep it stuck. I don't even know if that's really Al. They saying it's Al. But I don't know. I don't know if that's really Al Heyman. So, we gotta, we have to be realistic. You know what I mean? We gotta keep it a stack. You know, you can't sit here and tell boss, oh yeah, man, Al Heyman said that, man, he ain't gonna work with, you know, nobody from Top Rank. That's cap. You've never heard nobody from PBC say, we are not gonna work with any other organizations. You don't hear things like that. They don't talk like that at PBC. That's not what they do. You're not gonna hear them say, "Oh, yeah, man, we ain't gonna work with nobody from you know, we ain't gonna work with nobody from you know, we ain't working with nobody from you know what I'm saying, Top Rank." My bad, y'all. They doing these construction. They got these forklifts. You know. My bad, y'all. Hold on, let me back up. You know, y'all getting that real deal, Holyfield. Yeah. Like I said before, you ain't never heard that, right? So all this stuff about, oh, you know, this therapy session that Terrence Crawford had. Like I say, that's his viewpoint. That's his mindset. You know, that apparently that's how he views things, but it's not reality. This just got caused by this thing. It ain't reality. You know what I'm saying? You can't sit there and say, oh, they froze me out, this, that, and the third, but then, you know, you leave your promoter. If PBC was the reason why you didn't get these.